Minister, let's talk about the state of Ukraine's economy. What does it look like right now?
Today, Ukrainian's economy is demonstrating its resilience and non-fragility. According to our estimations, Ukrainian economy may fall by 36% by the end of the year, but in comparison, Russian economy will fall only to 4.6%. Having those revenues, Russia can do this massive strikes again and again every day. And I'm talking about here the need for zero profits for the aggressor and full embargo on all the export that brings Russia most revenues. According to our president, Mr. Zelensky, sanctions are the most humane weapon. They don't kill people, but they don't let the aggressor to kill Ukrainian people as massively as the aggressor does it. And we speak about complete embargo sanctions on the aggressor, and we know that world may lose millions and billions of dollars imposing sanctions, but at the same time, if the world does not do it, Ukraine will lose billions of life. And this is why it's always important to speak about this help from the world to Ukraine in the form of sanctions.
We're at a Rebuild Ukraine conference. What are the first steps? What do you think the first steps are to rebuilding Ukraine? What are you looking for?
First of all, we want the world to know that now in Ukraine, we are very resilient and very strong. Only 11% of enterprises have closed. The other ones are working. People are working, enterprises are working. We are paying taxes, creating jobs. And no matter the war, Ukraine demonstrates its resilience. So we want the world to know that we are, even on our path to the victory, we are ready to attract investments. We started our cooperation with MIGA agency, and the MIGA agency allocated $30 million for this year, and we are talking about the bigger amount of money for the next year. And I hope that we hope in the Ministry of Economy of Ukraine that this agency will ensure investments to Ukraine, both from abroad and both inside of the Ukraine. And also we have launched Advantage Ukraine platform. It's an online platform where all the industries which are very good for investment are located, and the investor may see the number of the fields to invest, and the application will be reviewed by the Ukrainian government, and so we can attract investments to the field of IT, metallurgy, agriculture, military tech. And I would say that, for instance, military tech is one of the most innovative industries in Ukraine now, because, you know, in Ukraine now we are a training ground. We practice various new military technologies, drones, very modern equipment, and that's why this industry is also very attractive for investments. And we want the world to know that our critical and energy infrastructure was ruined. Today we had missile strikes, and some of the energy infrastructure was also ruined today, but nevertheless, you couldn't imagine the speed the workers from these energy stations are repairing this destroyed infrastructure, because Ukrainians want to work, Ukrainians want to live, they want to save their businesses, to save working places, to save their profits. And you know, today I was amazed by a new application Ukrainians produced on the App Store. This application lets your calendar know when do we have a blackout, so that people could plan their work, plan their meetings, plan their schedule. So we are fighting, but we need the world to understand that Ukraine will not give up. We are on our path to the victory.
How do you make foreign investors feel comfortable in a landscape of where governance, regulation, counter-corruption, all of these elements are so important?
At the moment, at this time of brutal war, we are ruining a lot of stereotypes about Ukraine. And we believe that our actions, the actions of the government, will soon make Ukraine an investment mecca. And what I mean by that is that we started a lot of deregulation practices. The slogan of the Ministry of Economy of Ukraine is there should be less state in the economy. The state should protect, but the state should not interfere with enormous regulation, with big taxes, and so on. And at the beginning of the war, we introduced a lot of tax incentives for the business to work freely, to work to produce more profits. We also believe that international investors will come to Ukraine and will be able to guarantee their investments with the help of MIGA agency. And all this together with the rule of law we are now trying to introduce in Ukraine. We know how much it is important to work with not corrupt institutions which work on the principle of the rule of law. And you know, Ukraine today is Ukrainian institutions are a really strong team. They, governmental institution, MPs, they all work and support each other to make Ukraine attractive for investment, even in the times of war. So we do believe that a lot of stereotypes about Ukraine will be ruined, and the investors will look at Ukraine as a country worth their time, money, and ideas.
Lastly, let's talk about aid from the international community. What you've been seeing from Canada, from the US, from the EU. Has it been enough? What more are you looking for?
We are very grateful for all the support we have received from the EU, from US, from Canada, from all the countries in the world. We are very grateful for military support, for weapons, for humanitarian aid, for financial aid. But we all should understand that at this particular moment, Ukraine on the eastern part of Europe is defending the whole civilized world and European and good values from our aggressor. We are the one to fight for the whole world. And we hope that the world with its financial help will understand and will not leave us alone in this, on this battlefield.